You know what I read this morning? That plus size women are now the new skinny bitches. That's what we like to read in the morning. Matter of fact, now that we're done with all the graduations and all the holidays of eating, I've decided I'm a vegan now, everybody. You see all this? It is now pure vegetable fat. It's the good fat, I tell my doctor. It's the good fat. Now, they say at Weight Watchers, a way to lose weight is try eating all your meals naked in front of a mirror. Yeah, well, guys, I did that for about a week at the Olive Garden. Yeah, now I get free breadsticks for life. Now, I read in New York in the paper, this supermodel said she didn't need to eat because she liked the taste of air. Evidently, she has never ridden the subway in New York City in July. Now, I was thinking about that, though, and I said, hey, I like the taste of air when Cinnabons come out of the oven at IKEA. That's why I like that. And I recently went to L.A. to do some comedy, and the women in L.A. have gotten so thin that when I went to this comedy club, they actually didn't believe me that I was a comedian. They thought I was an entire comedy group. Honest to God. I said, that is crazy. But when I was in L.A., I said, all right, you know what? I'm going to break down. I'm going to try the celebrity diet. Now, that was just weird. Because once I ate a couple of celebrities, actually, I only ate one, Justin Bieber. But somebody had to. Exactly. Now, you mentioned I've been on Louis a couple of times. The first time I was on Louis was the best, because I got to play a homeless woman that vomited on Louis' shoes on 6th Avenue, because I get the best roles. And then, like, a couple of months later, I run into Louis the Comedy Club. So, like an idiot, you know, I go running up to him, and I go, hey, Louis, it's me, Pat, your homeless woman. And I go in for the big kiss, and he just gives me this look as if to say, oh, my God. Did I get drunk one night and bang some homeless woman on the way home? But nothing else matters, guys, in this life. You want to know why? Because my husband still thinks I'm sexy. Of course I drug him. And you know how I know love is blind? Every year on our wedding anniversary, he goes out and gets me a new black lace sexy negligee like I wore on our honeymoon. But he gets it for me in the exact same size 5. And then he says to me, kind of like in a Barry White voice, he goes, oh baby, it still looks so good on you. You still look so sexy in it. It still fits you just like a glove. And I said, that's right, honey, because it only fits on my fucking hand. We nicknamed it my OJ negligee. I can say that because OJ and I have the same birthday. Now you're all afraid of me. It's okay. So I have some other good news. My husband is also 7 years younger than me. I want some woos, ladies. So I did not want to go to his high school reunion and be the oldest woman there. But after he gave me a bottle of tequila and slipped me a roofie, I agreed to go. Thank you. So we got there, and everybody kind of acted like they knew me. They kept telling me how young I looked and how pretty I looked. So, like, in the end, I had this wonderful time. So the next day, they sent, like, a group photo with everyone's names on it. So I said to them, all right, well, who do they think I was? They were so nice. Like the class president or the prom queen? They thought I was the high school gym teacher. Wait, it's worse. Not just any gym teacher. The girls' softball coach. Yeah, I slipped myself a roofie after that. So I'll leave you with this, guys. It's starting to get time for vacation time. And last year on vacation, my husband and I went hiking in Utah. And I noticed there's a lot of white people here tonight. Are you okay, sir? There's a lot of white people here tonight. But in Utah, the white people, they're not like your regular white people. They're like a pasty white. I don't know if it's the Mormons or inbreeding. All I know is... Oh, we're in this barbecue place, like in the middle of nowhere. And I noticed that they were looking at us, and we were looking at them, and they were looking at us. And finally I said to my husband, honey, I think we're the only black people in here. I hope you guys enjoyed a little taste of Ceasar. That's my time. That's Ceasar. Thank you very much. Be kind to one another.